How are we looking on our celebrity murder? I'd love to have something to tell Under Sheriff Eckley.
There has been a bit of a development. Miss Jackson had sex with someone other than her husband the night of the murder. Tox screen showed signs of flunitrazepam in her system, so it may not have been consensual.
With whom, do we know?
Another patient at the rehab clinic, a Mr. Stephen Thompson.
CODIS hit?
He gave his DNA voluntarily. His cousin was reported missing 3 years ago, and Stephen was next of kin. It turned out to be a false alarm, but the information is still in the system.
No good deed goes unpunished, I guess. See if Brass can bring him in on suspicion of rape.
All right. There's also some physical evidence, a ring, but we're still looking at where that fits.
Finding the person it fits might be a good start.
I'll be ready to go in just a moment. You might want to take a look at this before we leave. I've identified the leaf fragment from the crime scene. It's actually an entire young plant, Kalanchoe degramontiana, also known as Devil's Backbone, or my personal favorite, Mother of Thousands. It's a species native to Madagascar, fairly prolific. They're able to reproduce asexually by forming young plants like the one we found along the edges of their leaves.
What do you need? I'm gonna need to see some evidence before I go to a judge. Even if she hadn't been murdered, date rape is still rape.
Not only did you have intercourse with the victim, but she had roofies in her system when she was murdered.
Wait, murder? Roofies? What the hell? I don't know anything about that. Not when you ask like that. Look, yeah, we had sex pretty much every day this week, but she was a married woman. It's not the kind of thing you just blurt out. Yeah, I keep detailed records every time I get laid. How the hell would... Wait, yeah, maybe. We both got STD tests on the same day. I can give you my medical record number, whatever. You guys can look stuff like that up, right? I don't know what Clorinda's was.
Dr. Robbins, our coroner, can provide Clorinda's medical records to us. Write your number down and we'll look it up on the medical database.
No problem. I wish.
Would you try it on for us? On your left ring finger, please.
Like a wedding ring, huh? Sure, I'll try it on. It's a little big for me. I've always had skinny fingers. Look, it's a nice ring, but it ain't mine.
Steven did get tested for sexually transmitted diseases, just as he said. That's quite a laundry list of tests. He wasn't taking any chances.
She was tested for a wide range of STDs last week. She went the whole nine yards. HIV, gonorrhea, chlamydia, HPV, even syphilis. The results were all negative.
It appears Stephen was telling the truth. I find it unlikely that they would both have such comprehensive screening done at the same place and time, coincidentally. You're free to go, but we'd like to ask you some more questions.
Hey, sure. Somebody murdered my girlfriend. I want to help. I don't remember her saying anything, but she used the spa quite a bit. No, I was in my room, chilling out. Clorinda and I had just, you know, I was resting. Like somebody that would kill her? No, she never mentioned anything like that. She did gripe about this guy from work, though. Jack Shell, I think his name was. I don't know all the details, but I guess he and Clorinda had this rivalry going. And her marriage was pretty messed up, obviously. Probably. She left him a message last night. Oh, God, you don't think... That crazy bastard!
Mr. Thompson, I understand your feelings, but take it from me, it does not pay to get ahead of the evidence. We'll find Clorinda's killer. Rest assured, can you think of anything that might help us find Clorinda's killer?
I don't know what else to say. I don't think I really had a chance to know everything about her life yet.
I believe you're free to go.
Hey, thanks. If you need me, I'll be back at the rehab center. If I ever needed to be surrounded by shrinks, it's now.
Hey, I got Ernie Goldwasser down here. He wants to know the results of his wife's autopsy. I can stall him for a while, but if you want to be the one who tells him his wife was murdered, then you need to get over to my office right away.
Hello. We're from the Las Vegas Crime Lab. Are you Jack Shell?
Why, by my stars and bars, indeed I am. What can I do for you? I'm always willing and able to assist our men and women in law enforcement.
We're investigating the death of Clorinda Jackson. We understand you both had shows at the Silver Skies Casino.
Hold on. Did you just say that Clorinda died? She's dead? Oh, my dear Lord, how on earth? What happened?
We're not quite sure yet.
But you folks wouldn't be here talking to me if you didn't think she'd been murdered. This is just the most awful thing I've ever heard in my whole life. Clorinda, she was a dear, dear sweet friend, and just a magnificent talent. We shall not see another like her again in this business, I'll tell you that. She will be profoundly missed.
You considered Miss Jackson a close personal friend, but might there have been a certain amount of professional rivalry?
No. Well, if anything, I'd call it sibling rivalry, pure and simple. We'd both grown up together in show business. Had our share of ups and downs, let me tell you what. And then, by chance, we found ourselves here in Sin City, both with shows at the Silver Skies. Her show'd come in right after mine in the, you know, main showroom. You see, I play the lounge. But anyway, we still share some crew and some staff, and even some audience, I'd say. There was a certain amount of competitiveness, sure, but why would you ask a leading question like that? Did someone say something?
Mr. Shell.
Now, please, call me Jack. My friends all call me Jack. Now, did someone say I had it out for Clorinda or something? Because that most assuredly was not the case. And I definitely have to say that person is lying to you.
Mr. Shell.
Jack.
Jack. I'm afraid we're going to need you to establish your alibi during the time Clorinda was murdered.
And to tell you the truth, I'm not really sure how I'd be able to verify this for you, but I'd be willing to swear on a stack of Bibles that I was at my home last night, by myself, fast asleep.
Do you often go to bed so early?
I tell you, I learned the very hardest way that you will not enjoy longevity in this business if you insist on burning your candle at both ends. So, I just tossed that sumbitch candle as far away from me as I could. I cannot tell you the number of lives that could be saved each year if they'd just heed my living example.
I'm sure that's true, Jack.
Look, be straight with me. You don't honestly believe that I had something to do with killing Clorinda, now do you?
Did you ever see Clorinda have words with anyone? A disgruntled employee, perhaps? Maybe a problem with management?
No. Now, look, you can't have me speaking out of school now, can you? I mean, it don't feel right to talk about rumors and innuendos and such. But, well, I don't think it was really very much of a secret that she and Ernest, that's her husband, they weren't getting along too well. And, you know, surprise, surprise, I mean, Clorinda's the fourth Mrs. Ernest Goldwasser, so I'm pretty sure Ernest's not too good at communicating with the wife. I could not honestly tell you whether or not I have seen that or any other particular piece of jewelry before. It's just not the sort of thing I concern myself with when it comes to making a person's acquaintance.
Jack, thank you for your cooperation. If we have any further questions, is this the best place to reach you?
That's right, right here. You need anything, anything at all, I will get it for you. I'm 1,000% behind you. I wish you Godspeed.